Hi students, so today we are going to see the design of gears. So this part we already studied in your last semester, so I just want to recall your attention to those you studied in your last semester, and we can try one or two problems in the design of gears. So the first design procedure for this spur gear is the calculation of the WT, that is the tangential tooth plot. So the basic equation for calculating the tangential tooth plot from the power and velocity transmitted is WT is equal to P by V into CS, where P is the power transmitted in watts and V is the pitch line velocity in meter per second, CS is the service factor, and V, that is the pitch line velocity, can be calculated using the equation pi d n by 60, where d is the diameter, that is pitch circle diameter, and n is the speed in RPM. Then service factor. So service factor can be taken from a table and based on the type of load and the type of services. So type of load is steady, light, medium shock, heavy shock, etc. And type of services is intermittent or 3 hours per day, 8 to 10 hours per day, continuous 24 hours per day. So usually we are going for a design of an 8 hours per day of steady type load. And since that is the condition, our service factor is mostly case is 1. And if that is not the case, then we have to depend this table for to take the service factor CS. And this table is given for the service factor for a enclosed well lubricated gears. And if the gear is not enclosed and it is not well lubricated, then the service factor can be calculated from the value of the table divided by the 0.65. So this is how we select the service factor. So after calculating the tangential tooth plot, means before going to the next step, we have to substitute the values of this D in terms of pitch. That is, we know that circular pitch PC is equal to M into pi into D by pi D by T. D by T is the ratio of diameter to the tooth, so that is module. So pitch circular pitch PC is equal to pi into M, and also the D diameter, pitch circle diameter, is equal to module into the teeth. Then the equation, that is V is equal to pi dn by 60. In that equation, we can substitute M into T instead of D, that is V is equal to pi m T by 6, Tn by 60. Then whereas pi m is equal to Pc, that is circular pitch, so V is equal to Pc Tn by 60. Next is the factor, we have to apply the Lewis equation. So Lewis equation is equation which is meant for the design of gears, which is given by WT, that is tangential tooth plot, is equal to sigma W B Pc into Y. Where sigma W is the working stress, allowable working stress, B is the phase width, Pc is the circular pitch. And instead of Pc, from the previous slide, we can substitute the value of pi m. And instead of W, we can write sigma 0 into CV, B pi m into Y. Where sigma 0 is the allowable static stress, sigma W is the working static stress, and CV is the velocity factor. So the Lewis equation is applied for which of the weaker. So if we know that in a mating gears, two gears will be there. One will be driven and one will be the driver. So whichever is the weaker, we will apply the Lewis equation for that gear. So how we are considering which is the weaker is that if the two gears of same material, then the smallest gear, that is the pinion, is the weaker. Hence we will apply this Lewis equation for the smallest gear, that is the pinion. If the both pinion and gear, that is the smallest gear and largest gear, is made of two kind of material, then we will decide whichever is the weaker is based on some calculation. That is, we will calculate the product of sigma W into Y or sigma 0 into Y. So either sigma W into Y or sigma 0 into Y. Say we can take sigma 0 into Y. Sigma 0 is the allowable stress into Y of both pinion and gear. So sigma 0 of Y, sigma 0 into Y of pinion, and sigma 0 into Y of gear. We will calculate the both value, and whichever value is smaller, that may be this weaker part. Then we will do the design for that part. So And that sigma W into Y is called the strength factor of the gear. Then we have to calculate the value of Y. So Y is calculated based on this some criteria that is for 14.5 degree composite and full depth involute system, Y is equal to 0.124 minus 0.684 by T. T is the number of tooth. And for 20 degree full depth involute system, 0.154 minus 0.912 by T. And for 20 degree subsystem, it is 0.175 minus 0.841 by T. So this is how we calculate the Y. Then that Y, using that Y, we will calculate the strength factor and we will decide whichever is the weaker. Then next is the phase width. Phase width B can be taken as 9.5 m or 12.5 m. In between these values for a cut teeth and for a cast teeth, the value of B may be taken between 6.5 into m and 9.5 into m. So m is the motive. So this is that part. Next, we have substituted that sigma W is equal to sigma 0 into CV. So, where CV is the velocity factor and sigma 0 is the allowable static stress, W is the working stress. Then, this CV is the velocity factor which can be taken using the consideration of the velocities, how much velocity is running. So the velocity up to 12.5 meter per second, we can take CV is equal to 3 by 3 plus V. And if it is operating cut gears, carefully cut gears at velocities up to 12.5 meter per second, it is 4.5 by 4.5 plus V. And for 20 meter per second, it is 6 by 6 plus V. So based on these, whichever is the condition, we will select the value CV and we will substitute in this equation for calculating the working stress. Next part is we have to calculate the dynamic load using the equation WT plus WI. In case WI is equal to 21V BC plus WT and 21 root of BC plus WT, and whereas WT is equal to P by V, since and P is the power in watts and V is the velocity, which in meter per second. Next step is we have to find out the static tooth load, and using the equation WS is equal to sigma E B pi M into Y. And we have to see whether WS is greater or not than the WD. So always the WS should be greater than WD. If not, our design is not correct. We have to redesign the entire thing. So finally, we have to find out the VR tooth load by the relation WW is equal to DPPQK. So whereas DP is the pitch circle diameter, V is the pitch face width, Q is the ratio factor, which is equal to 2TG by TG plus TP for an external gears, and for internal gears it is 2TG by TG minus TP, and K is the load stress, which is given in Newton per mm square. Where is the velocity factor in this part, which is equal to TG by TP. So that is about the design procedure. Now we can see a problem. So in this problem, a brown spur gear rotating at 600 rpm drives a cast spur gear at a transmission ratio of 4:1. The allowable static stress for the bronze pinion and the cast iron gear are 84 MPa and 105 MPa respectively. The pinion has 16 standard 20 degree full depth involute teeth of module 8 mm. The face width of both gears is 90 mm. Find the power that can be transmitted from the standpoint of strength. So the question demands to calculate the power. There are some given values. What are the given values in this problem is that a bronze spur pinion rotating at 600 rpm, that is speed of the pinion, we can write it as N suffix P as 600, which drives a cast iron spur gear transmission ratio of 4:1. So TG by TP is equal to 4:1. Then we have given the allowable static stress of pinion and gear. So allowable static stress is the which is denoted by sigma 0. Then both pinion and gear is given. So pinion we can write P and for gear we can write as G. So sigma 0 P O P and sigma O G. which is equal to 84 megapascal, which can be written as 84 newton per mm square, and sigma 0 g, which is equal to 105 megapascal, is equal to 105 newton per mm square. Next, the pinion has 16 standard involute teeth. That is pinion number of teeth, that the TP is equal to 16 and module M is equal to 8 mm, and the face width of both gears is 90 mm, hence B is equal to 90 mm. So we have to calculate the power. That was our final part. So before going to the discussion of all this part, the thing is that the pinion is made up of bronze, whereas the gear is made up of cast iron. That is, two gear and pinion is made up of two different kind of material. Hence, we have to first calculate whichever is the weaker. Then we have to apply the Lewis equation for the weaker gear to calculate the power, or for calculating the WT. Okay. So, how we are calculating the power is that we have the equation of first initial equation, that WT is equal to P. P is the power by V. V is the pitch line velocity into CS, where CS is the service factor. And hence, we are considering this for a steady state load and for 8 to 10 hours of servicing. Hence, the service factor CS is equal to 1. So, WT is equal to P by V. From that, we can write P is equal to WT into V. So, we have to calculate WT and V for the equation. Okay. So, power that can be transmitted is equal to P is equal to WT into V. And for V, we have the equation V is equal to pi dn by 60, pi dn by 60. Okay, so for calculating this pi dn by 16, which all the datas we have here is, we have the data of pinion here. So with the help of the pinion data, we can calculate the V. So pi dp np by 60, from which we can calculate the, since if it, the, all the data is given for pitch pinion only, we calculate like this. If the data is given for the gear, we can calculate like that. In for this WT, for WT, we have to see whichever is the weaker. Okay. So first we have to calculate the DP. For DP, we have the equation M into TP. So M is given as 8 and TP is given as 16. So M, dp is equal to m, tp is equal to 8 into 16, which is equal to 128 mm, which is equal to 0.128 m. Then np, whether np is available, that is speed of pinion is already given, that is 600. So using that all equation, we can calculate the V. So V is equal to pi dp np by 60 is equal to pi into 0.128 into 600 divided by 60, from which we can get the value as 4.02 meter per second. So one part is over, that is V find out. Next, we have to find out the value of WT. WT, for the WT, we have our Lewis equation. And for Lewis equation, we have B, we have the value of pi, we have the value of M, and we have to calculate for which thing we have to apply this. For that, we have to calculate the value of y. We have to calculate the value of y. For calculating the value of y, we already see that we require pitch line velocity. Y can be taken from the pitch line velocity. And we have to decide whichever is weaker. For whichever is the weaker, we have to find that sigma. We have one equation, sigma w is equal to sigma 0 into CV. Sigma 0 into CV. CV is the velocity factor. Okay. That from here, so we have to find out sigma w into y or sigma 0 into y. Okay, we have to find out either whichever is weaker. Y, how we are finding? We have to find out either sigma w 0 into y or sigma w into y, and based on that we will design whichever is weaker. So for sigma w into y, first we have to calculate the y. Y can be based on this equation. In this equation, it is given as 20 degree full depth involute system. Hence, this is the equation that we are going to take for calculating y. Then sigma w is there, and for that, this equation is there. Sigma w is equal to sigma 0 into Cv. Okay. So sigma 0 is already given in the question, and Cv is not given in the question. For calculating the Cv, we have to use either of these equation. Since our velocity is, here our velocity is 4.02, that is 4.02 is less than 12, we can take Cv is equal to 3 by 3 plus V. So using this equation, we can calculate the Cv, and using that calculation Cv, we can calculate the sigma W here. So that is how we are proceeding in this equation. Okay. So since the pitch line velocity is less than 12.5 meter per second, the velocity factor Cv is equal to 3 divided by 3 plus V. V is equal to 4.02 here. So 3 divided by 3 plus 4.02, which is equal to 0.427. Then next is that 20 degree full depth involute teeth, YP is equal to 0.154 minus 0.912 divided by TP. Similarly, we have to find out YG also. So 0.154 minus 0.912 divided by TG. So TP is already given in the question, that is 16, and YP is equal to 0.097. And TG, since we have the velocity ratio is 4:1, that is TG by TP is equal to 4. From this, TG is equal to 4 into TP. So instead of TG, we can write 4 into TP. TP is equal to 16. So 4 into 16, which is equal to 0.14. Next, we have to find out W into, that is sigma OP into YP and sigma OG into YG. Sigma OP into YP. Sigma OP is already given in the equation, that is 84. Into YP, is, we calculated previously, that is 0.9097, and sigma OG into YG is equal to 105 into 0.14 is equal to 14.7. So whichever is smaller, this one is smaller. So that is the pinion part is smaller, hence the pinion is weaker. Hence we have to apply the Lewis equation for the pinion. Since sigma OP into YP is less than sigma OG into YG, therefore the pinion is weaker. Now the Lewis equation can be applied for the pinion. That for WT is equal to sigma W P, sigma WP B pi M YP. So this P should become a suffix. Okay. So we can calculate that value. So this is all for pinion. So we can substitute the values for, then instead of sigma WP, we can write sigma OP into CV. Okay, so sigma OP into CV we already calculated, that is 0.427 into pi into modulus 8, then YP is, we have calculated as 0.097, and from this equation we will calculate the value of WT is 7,870 newton. Okay, so now we have find out WT and we have find out the V. So substituting the equation, WT is equal to V 780 into 4.02 is equal to 31.64 kilowatt. That is how the power transmitted. So this is our answer for the question. So that is for now. The next problem can be done in the next class.